Hello everyone, welcome to Mechanical Vibration lecture. In the last lecture we discussed about the eigenvalues, and in this lecture we are going to discuss the solution for eigenvectors or multi-degree of freedom system. So first I'll briefly discuss about the things till this time we have done, then we'll go to get the eigenvectors. So first of all, we considered the governing equation for undamped free vibration of multi-degree of freedom system, that was mx double dot plus kx is equal to 0. And for this particular system, we developed this equation and we got mass matrix as m1, 0, 0, 0, m2 and 0, 0, m3. And stiffness matrix was something like this, k1 plus k2 minus k2, 0, minus k2 and this k2 plus k3, minus k3, minus k3 and k3. And then we assumed the solution as x is equal to phi x and qt. Qt was the function of time and this was the function of spatial coordinate, and the complete response of the system was the function of space plus and time coordinate. And here then we got the x dot, that was phi x q dot and x double dot phi x q double dot, and we said and we proved also that qt can be taken as the solution of simple harmonic motion, that was a cos omega t plus b sin omega t, and that's why double dot was minus omega square phi x q t. And when we replaced the x and x double dot in the governing equation, we got k minus omega square m phi q is equal to 0. So we said for non-trivial solution q and phi must be equal to 0. Then we got this equation, k minus omega square m is equal to 0. So for the trivial solution, we said the determinant of this k minus omega square m is equal to 0. And this was called as characteristic or frequency equation. And in this particular equation, we replaced that lambda equals to 1 by omega square. Then this equation took a form of lambda k minus m, and determinant of this is equal to 0. Then we multiply this equation by k inverse and we got lambda identity matrix I minus k square k inverse m, and determinant of is equal to 0. And then we defined one new matrix, that was dynamical matrix. So we called k inverse multiplied by m is equal to D matrix. So this equation becomes lambda I minus D matrix, and determinant of this is equal to 0. So this equation was the polynomial equation of nth order. Here n is equal to degree of freedom. So in this particular example, we considered the 3 degree of freedom system. So this equation was third degree or cubic equation in lambda. So this equation give us a 3 roots in the form of lambda, lambda 1, lambda 2 and lambda 3. And here the lambda 1 was 1 by omega 1 square, and so omega 1 square becomes 1 by lambda, and omega 1 was 1 by lambda 1 under root. So omega 1 was the natural frequency. So now we go get the values of eigenvectors. To get the value of eigenvectors, we replace the values of lambda I in this equation and we code lambda I minus D and phi I is equal to 0. Here phi I is eigenvector. So in that particular example, we got this, the determinant of this lambda I minus D was lambda, this was the identity matrix I 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0 and this is 0, 0, 1, and D dynamical matrix was M by K 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, and determinant of this is equal to 0. And when we solved this equation, determinant of this, we got omega 1 is equal to 0.44504 under root K by M radian per second. And omega 2 we got 1.2471 under root K by M radian per seconds, and omega 3 was 1.8025 under root K by M. So now these values from the last lecture we are going to use to find out the eigenvectors. So once the natural frequencies are known to us, the eigenvectors, also called as mode shapes, can be calculated using lambda I minus D multiplied by phi I is equal to 0. Here I is equal to 1, 2 up to 3 if we are talking about 3 degree of freedom system. And phi I is phi 1 associated with I and phi 2 associated with I natural frequency, and phi 3 is associated with ith natural frequency. So this is ith mode shape. This vector is called as mode shape. So now we are going to find out the first mode shape. So to find out the first mode shape, we consider omega 1 is equal to 0.44504 under root k by m. And if we find out the lambda, so lambda 1 was 1 by omega 1 square. So if we calculate this 1 by omega 1 square, we got lambda 1 is equal to 5.0489 m by k. So now we replace this value into this equation. So this equation is lambda 1 I matrix minus dynamical matrix multiplied by phi 1 is equal to 0. So now this lambda 1 is equal to 5.0489. So 5.0489 m by k, and this is identity matrix 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Minus dynamical matrix is m by k, here m by k and this matrix. So this is m by k and this is 1 1 1 1 2 2 1 2 3 and this is multiplied by phi 1 associated with first natural frequency, phi 2 associated with first natural frequency, and phi 3 associated with first natural frequency is equal to 0, 0, 0. So now if we solve this, this becomes 5 point. So m by k can be taken as common and we can send it to right side, which that becomes 0. So 5.0489 minus 1 becomes 4.0489, and this is 0 minus 1, this becomes minus 1, and this again 0 minus 1 becomes minus 1, and this is 0 minus 1 becomes again minus 1, and this multiplied by 1, so this is 5.0489 minus 2, so this becomes 3.0489, and this is again 0 minus 2, so this becomes minus 2, and this becomes minus 1, and this becomes 0 minus 2, so this becomes minus 2, and now this is 1, so 5.0489 minus 3, so this becomes 2.0489 multiplied by phi 1 1 phi 2 1 and phi 3 1 is equal to 0, 0, 0. So in this equation, this is the system of, this equation is the system of three homogeneous linear equations. Linear equations in the three unknowns. Three unknowns are phi 1 1, phi 2 1 and phi 3 1, and three unknowns. phi 1 1, phi 2 1 and phi 3 1. Phi 1 1 means phi 1 associated with first natural frequency, because in this particular equation we replaced lambda I as 1 by omega 1 square, and phi 2 associated with first natural frequency and phi 3 associated with first natural frequency. So these are unknowns. So now to solve this equation, we can express any two in the form of third. So in this particular equation, we express phi 2 1 and phi 3 1 in form of phi 1 1. So from first row of this matrices, we can write minus from the first row, this matrix system, we can write minus phi 2 1 and minus phi 3 1 is equal to minus 4.048951 1, or we can write phi 2 1 plus phi 3 1 is equal to 4.048951 1. And from the second row we can write, we are writing because we want to express phi 2 1 and phi 3 1 in form of phi 1 1, that's why we are writing in this form. So from second row we can write phi 3 1 multiplied by this term, so this is 3.048953 1, sorry, phi 2 1, this is phi 2 1, and minus 2 phi 3 1 is equal to phi 1 1. So now we are having these two equations, this is first equation and this is second equation. So here what we are trying to do, we want to find out the value of phi 2 1 and phi 3 1 in form of phi 1 1. So now to solve these two equation, we can multiply the equation 1 by 2. So we can say, if we multiply the equation 1 by 2 and then we can add these two, so we can say the equation 1 multiplied by 2, then we'll add equation 2. This gives us phi 2 1 plus 2 phi 3 1 is equal to 2 times of 4.048951 1, and this equation will add this equation into this, so this becomes 3.048952 1 minus 2 phi 3 1 is equal to phi 1. So on the addition of these two, we can say this will get cancelled out. This will get cancelled out, and this becomes 2 plus 3, 5.048952 1 is equal to 1 plus 2 multiplied by 4.048951 1. So from using this, we can express phi 2 1 in form of this, so this becomes 1 plus 2 times of 4.0489 divided by this 5.04 5, 1, 1. So if we insert these value in the calculator, then we'll have 1.521 becomes 1.8019 times of 5, 1, 1. This, and similarly, now if we use this value into this first equation, if we use this value into this equation, then this becomes 1.8019511. At the place of 521, we replace this value, then this becomes this plus 531 is equal to this one, 4.0489511. So 531 becomes 4.0489 minus 1.8019511. So if we solve this, we'll get 2.2470511. So 531 is equal to this one. So by using this value and this value, we can represent the first mode shape. So we can say first mode shape 51 is equal to 511, 521 and 531. So if we take 511, or we can write 511, and 521 becomes 1.8019511, and we calculated that 531 is equal to 2.2470511. So we can take 511 as common, and this becomes 1.8019 and 2.2470. So this is our first mode. Here 511 can be taken arbitrarily, and in most of the cases this 511 is the just for the scaling purpose. So in most of the cases 511 taken as unit 1. So if we take 511 as 1 or 2, so this will not change the shape of this mode shape, but it will change the size of mode shape, or you can say this will amplify the mode shape. So we can say the shape of the mode shape is not going to affected by the choice of this arbitrary constant. So this is the for the scaling purpose. So in most of the cases we choose 511 as 1. So now we'll calculate for the second mode. So second mode means 51 associated with second natural frequency, 52 associated with second natural frequency, and 53 associated with second natural frequency. So to get the 52, we'll replace the value of lambda 2. This is identity matrix, this is dynamical matrix, and multiplied by 52 is equal to 0. So in this particular equation, we replace the value of lambda 2. So in this means in this equation, we'll replace the value of lambda 2, we'll get the second mode. So lambda 2 was, because omega 2, lambda 2 equals to 1 by omega 2 square, and as we know that the omega 2 was 1.2471 under root k by m. So if we calculate this value using the calculator, we'll have lambda 2 equals to 0.6430 m by k. So if we replace this value into this equation, we'll have 0.6430 m by k, then this is identity matrix minus dynamical matrix, which is m by k 1 1 1 1 2 2 1 2 3 and multiplied by phi 1 associated with second natural frequency, phi 2 2 and this is phi 3 2 is equal to 0 0 0. So from this we'll have, this becomes m by k can be taken out and can be sent to the right side. So this 1 multiplied by 0.6430 becomes 0.6430 minus 1. So this would be minus of 0.3570. So this becomes minus 0.3570 and 0 minus 1, this becomes minus 1. And again 0 minus 1 becomes minus 1 and this is 0 minus 1 becomes minus 1. This becomes 1 multiplied by 0.6430 becomes 0.6430 minus 2. So this becomes minus 1.3570 and this 0 minus 2 becomes minus 2. Similarly 0 minus 1 minus 1, 0 minus 2 minus 2 and this becomes 0.6430 multiplied by 1 minus 3 becomes minus 2.3570 and multiplied by this model phi 1 2 phi 2 2 and this is phi 3 2 second model vector, this is equal to 0 0 0. So now this is the system of three algebraic equations. So three algebraic equation in three unknowns. Three unknowns are phi 1 2 phi 2 2 phi 3 2. So three algebraic equation can be solved simultaneously. So we'll solve these equations. So from the first row of these matrices we can write, from the first row, from this, this multiplied by this, and again we'll express the phi 2 2 and phi 3 2. We express the phi 2 2 and phi 3 2 in form of phi 1 2. So now we can write phi 2 2 multiplied by 1 minus 1, this becomes minus phi 2 2 and this becomes minus phi 3 2 and this becomes minus phi 1 2 multiplied by this, and if we take this on right side this becomes plus. So this becomes plus 3570 phi 1 2. So this is our equation 1 for this particular second mode. And from the right second row of these matrices we can write minus 1.3570 multiplied by phi 2 2 and 2 multiplied by this. So this becomes 2 phi 3 2 and minus 1 multiplied by phi 1 2, and if we take on the right side this becomes phi 1 2. This is our second equation. So if we solve these two equations, on solving these two equations we can apply the first equation multiplied by 2, then we'll subtract the equation second from first. So we'll write equation first multiplied by 2 2, then we'll subtract the second equation from this system. This gives minus, if we perform this operation, then this becomes minus 2522 minus 2532 and 2 multiplied by 0.3570512, and now we subtract second equation, this equation, from this system, and then this becomes minus 1.3570522 and minus 2532 is equal to 512. So if we subtract this equation from this, then this becomes plus, this becomes plus, this becomes minus. Then this minus 2532 get cancelled out with plus 2532. So this is cancelled out. And if we subtract from minus 2, we subtract 1.3570, then we'll have minus 0.643522, and this is 2 and this is 1, this is 2 multiplied by 370, and so this becomes, if we calculate this, this becomes 0 minus 0.286512. So if we do 522 is equal to minus 0.286 divided by minus 0.643, so we'll get 0.4450511. So this becomes 0.4450511. So 52512. So 522 in the form of 512 is 0.4450 times of 512. And similarly, we can find out 532 in form of 5. If we replace this value into this equation, then this becomes minus, if we replace this value into this equation, then this becomes 0.4450. At place of 522, we write this 512 minus 532 is equal to 0.3570512, and so this is 532 becomes minus 0.8020512. So now if we write the second mode shape, so second mode shape can be expressed as 52 equals to 512, 522, 532. So this is 512, and 522 in the form of this is 0.4450512. So this is 0.4450512, and 532 in the form of 512, this is minus 0.8020512. So we can write, if we take the 512 as common, this becomes 1.0.4450, and this is minus 0.8020. So this is our second mode. Here again 512 is a scaling factor, so we can choose this as unit. So second mode shape is this one. So now we can calculate on the similar line, we can calculate the third mode shape. So now third, mode shape. So third mode shape is phi 3 is equal to phi 1 3, phi 2 3 and phi 3 associated with third natural frequency. So for this we'll replace the value of lambda 3, and lambda 3 is equal to 1 by omega 3 square, and omega 3 we calculated as 3 was 1 point, so this becomes 1.8025 and root k by m square. If we solve this, then this becomes 0.3078 m by k. So if we replace the lambda 3 into this equation, or we can say lambda 3, this is identity matrix, this is dynamical matrix, and this is phi 3 is equal to 0. If we replace this value into this, then this becomes lambda 3 is 0.3070 m by k. this is 0001001 minus m by k, and this is 1 1 1 1 2 2 1 2 3, and this is 5 1 3 5 2 3, and 5 3 3 is equal to 0 0 0. So on solving this equation we'll have, then m by k can be taken out and can be sent to the right side on 0. So this becomes 0 point, because 0.3070 multiplied by 1 minus 1, so this becomes minus 0.6922, and this becomes minus 1, and again this is 0 minus 1 minus 1, and again 0 minus 1, this is minus 1, and this is 1 multiplied by 0.3070 minus 2, so this becomes minus 1.6922, and this is 0 minus 2, so this is minus 2, 0 minus 1, this is minus 1, 0 minus 2, this is minus 2, and this is 0.3070 multiplied 1 minus 3, so this becomes minus 2.6922, and this is 5 1 3 5 2 3 and 5 3 3 is equal to 0 0 0. So if we solve this again, we'll find out 5 2 3 and 5 3 3 in form of 5 1 3. So if we take the first row of this matrices, we'll have 5 2 3 multiplied by minus 1, so this is minus, and again this is minus 5 3 3 is equal to 0.6922 5 1 3. This is equation 1. Similarly, the second equation becomes minus 1.6922 5 2 3 and then minus this multiplied by 2, then this is 2 5 3 3 is equal to, and this is multiplied by 1, then this is 5 1 3. This is second equation. So now solving these two equations, we'll get the 5 2 3 and 5 3 3 in the form of 5 1 3. So if we solve these equations, we'll have these two values, phi 2, 3 is minus 1.2468, phi 1, 3 and phi 3, 3 is 0.5544, phi 1, 3. So on the similar line we solve these two equations and we get these two parameters. So third mode shape can be expressed as, the third mode shape phi 3 is equal to phi 1 3, phi 2 3, and this is phi 3 3. So this is phi 1 3 and phi 2 3 in the form of phi 1 3 is minus 1.2468 phi 1 3, and phi 3 3 in the form of phi 1 3, this is 0.5544 phi 1 3. So this can be written as phi 1 3. And this becomes 1, this becomes 1.2468, and this becomes 0.5544. So this is our third mode shape. So in again, 513 is scaling parameter, or you can take it as unit. So this becomes third mode shape. So again, I'll say the values of 513, phi 1 2 or phi 1 1 in the first, second and third mode shape can be taken arbitrarily, but in general case you can take it as 1. So what does this mean? At this point of time we calculated all three mode shapes. So first mode shape was phi 1 1 and this vector, so we written over here, and our second mode shape was phi 1 2 and this vector, so we written here, and this was the third mode shape as we calculated phi 1 3 and this vector. So we written all the three mode shapes here. So now if we represent, or we want to understand what does this mean, so we can represent the in graphical manner. So first mode shape can be represented as, this is the position of first mass or first degree of freedom, which is phi 1 1, and relative to first, the position of second is 1.8019 times of phi 1 1. So this is 1.8019 times of this. This is unit. We taken as unit, phi 1 1 as unit. So this is the position of second relative to first, and this is 1.8019 times. So you can say this is phi 2 1, and relative to first, third is placed at 1.2470. So this is the position of third mass. So, and this is phi 3 1. So these are the positions of all three masses relative to each other, and this remains fixed. Or if we take this scaling parameter phi 1 1 as 2, then this all the position will get multiplied by 2. So we can say shape of this mode shape will not get changed, but the size of mode shape will get changed. That's why this scaling parameter can be taken arbitrarily, and in most of the cases we take them as unit. So this is the relative position of all the degrees of freedom. So this is called as mode shape. So similarly, the second mode shape graphically can be represented as, the first is at 1, phi 1 2. So this is phi 1 2, and the second is at 0.44 times of first. So 0.44 means somewhere at this place. So this is the position of second mass. So this is phi 2 2, and the position of third mass according to this at minus 8020 means somewhere at this place. And this is 5, 3, 2. So this is our second mode, means when the vibration of this system will take place with omega 2 or on the second natural frequency, the relative position of the system will be something like this. This is the configuration of this 3 degree of freedom system when it vibrates with omega 2. So this is the second mode shape. Similarly, third mode shape can be represented graphically as this is the position of first at this place. So this is 5, 1, 3, and the relative position of second is -1.2468 times of first. So minus means somewhere at this place, -1.24. So this is 5, 2, 3, and third position, position of third mass is 0.55 times of first. 0.55 times means approximately half of this, means at this. So this is the position of third and this is 5, 3, 3. So this is the third mode shape or relative position of this system when it vibrates with omega 3 will be something like this. So this is the graphical representation of all the mode shapes, mode shape 1, mode shape 2 and mode shape 3. So this is how we can interpret the mode shapes and we can represent them in the graphical manners. So in the next lecture we are going to read about the orthogonality of mode shapes. Thank you.